Hello everybody, today we are going to study the present continuous, el presente continuo, yes, we are going to study the present continuous, which is the use, cuando se usa, actions in progress, for actions in progress, okay, actions that are happening at this moment, actions that are happening at this moment, quiere decir, acciones que están pasando ahora, now, right now, at this moment, okay? So this is the use of the present continuous. The present continuous is formed with the verb to be, se forma con am, is, are, plus the verb with ing, es decir, al verbo le agregamos ing. I am eating my lunch, or she's cooking in the kitchen. For example, look at this woman. She is cooking in the kitchen now. Fíjense, el verbo es cook. Agrega ing, por eso hace cooking. Or they are playing football right now. The verb is play with ing is playing. They are playing football right now. Yes? Okay, so look at this picture. I am running a marathon now. I am running, the verb is run plus ing is running. Con la vocal más consonante, agregamos otra consonante, como en el caso de run. Remember, please, the verb to be, o si se olvidaron, the verb to be is I am, you are, he is, abreviado puede ser I'm, you're, or he's. I am, you are, he is. No puede faltar el verbo to be en este tiempo de verbo, o she is, it is, we are, o they are. Puede ser she is, it's, we're, o they're, if you want to abbreviate. The gerund. What? Me estarán preguntando, ¿qué? ¿Qué es eso? The gerund. Ok, gerund es el gerundio. In English is the verb with ing. And in Spanish, la ing significa la terminación ando, yendo. For example, go, going, study, studying, watch, watching. Some verbs change. Algunos verbos cambian. Fíjense, most verbs are ending in Y add ing. Los que terminan en Y agregan ing, quedan las dos juntas. Buy, buying, enjoy, enjoying. Most verbs add ing. La mayoría de los verbos solo agregan ing. Eat, eating, speak, speaking. But the verbs that end in E, los que terminan en E, se saca la E final y se agrega ING. Hope, hoping, write, writing, write, writing, drive, driving, dance, dancing. Es decir, no va la E y la I, sino que se borra definitivamente la E y se agrega ING, como en el caso de drive, driving, or dance, dancing. Verbs ending with one vowel and one consonant. Los verbos que terminan de una sola sílaba con una vocal y una consonante doblan la consonante. For example, jog, jogging. Sit, sitting. Fíjense, termina en T, agrego otra T. Run, running. Termina en N, agrego otra N. Stop, stopping. Termina en P, agrego otra P. ¿Para qué verbos? Son para los verbos que terminan en consonante y antes de la consonante hay una vocal. Examples. Let's see some examples, okay? With some pictures. For example, this one. The verb is drink. Okay? So, what is she doing? ¿Qué está haciendo ella? What is she doing? She is drinking coke. Fíjense el verbo siempre con ing y antes el verbo to be. Play, for example. Termina en Y, pero va con las dos I. La pregunta es, what are they doing? What are they doing? So, they are playing basketball. They are playing basketball. Siempre la ing en el verbo y antes el verbo to be, en este caso are. Or look at this picture. The verb is drive, okay? So he is driving a car. He is driving a car. What is he doing? He is driving a car. The verb here is run, vocal consonante, es decir que tiene que doblar la consonante. What are they doing? What are they doing? They are running a marathon. Running with double N. doble N porque está terminado en consonante y precedido de una vocal. They are running a marathon. So now, at this moment. Remember, no se olviden, por favor, para las actividades. Don't forget, remember, please. El verbo siempre lleva ing. Don't forget. El verbo siempre lleva ing. Y antes tienen que poner el verbo to be. Am o am not, is o isn't, are o aren't, en el caso de que sean oraciones negativas. For example, she isn't eating pizza. She is driving a car. Negative, affirmative. Thank you very much. See you soon. Bye bye.